I know him from two streets away, so I'll make my way into his house as a cat or a rat or...
I'll command the East Winds to mute and disguise your arrival.
And I'll give you the clouds to hide you.
I'll drain the life out of him. He won't catch a wink of sleep. Not in the night, not in the day. He'll live as a cursed man. For weeks and weeks, he'll waste away in agony. I might not be able to make his toilet paper and everything else he's inevitably hoarded disappear. But I can make his life miserable at least.
Whoa, you really wanted that toilet paper.
I'm down to the last roll, Morgana! While each of the witches chose their names for particular reasons, they're not their actual names, they're the names they've chosen to have within the coven. And for Lilith, I think she's picked this one because it's such a powerful name. Lilith in folklore she's the first wife of Adam. She's someone who told God himself to feck off. She's also known to be the first witch. She's, in a lot of folklore, she's considered to be the first ever witch. I feel that my Lilith chose that name because she thought that's really important. That's an important, weighty name, and what better name to have in this coven than to be named after the first witch. But then of course we have Aradia, who is in Italian mythology is considered to be the first witch and the daughter of the goddess Diana. So I think perhaps between Lilith and Aradia, they both think, no, I'm named after the first witch. But Lilith is right. She's the one who's got the right name. Aradia's wrong. I think she sees Morgana as clay to be molded. Morgana is the youngest, she's the newest member. There's so much she's still to learn, to experience, and I think the fact that she's got involved with this Macbeth thing and she's doing this and they've named themselves and they're this little trio, I think Lilith sees Morgana as someone who's going to be coming under their wing and is eventually going to be more like them. They're going to become bonded. I think she sees Morgana as a mentee to her mentoriness. Whereas Aradia, it's obviously been in the coven as long as Lilith has, and so I think they kind of have a long friendship. They're old friends, they know each other really well, and so they're always there to support each other. But I think Lilith thinks Aradia is a wee bit too dramatic. Instead of saying a couple of words, she'll say 100, and they're always poetic, and they're always these beautiful metaphors and these wonderful visuals that she does, but it takes so long, and Lilith just wants a straight answer. She just wants an answer, man. So I think she probably thinks Aradia needs to turn it down a wee notch with the drama. I don't think Lilith has any ulterior motives for doing this to Macbeth. I think when she found out about the idea, when she found out what was going on, I think she literally thought, doesn't matter, don't care. You had me and a man to torment. I mean, I think she just saw this picture or bio or whatever of this rich white man, this privileged man with all this privilege, thinking he can get away with anything, and she thought, great, let's get involved. I think she just, there's a rich white man to torment, she's there. That's it. There's literally nothing else. There's nothing. She has no other ulterior motive. She just thinks, yeah, I'm in. I think she thinks Hecate's a wee bit of a stick in the mud. Because she is. I mean, the Weird Sisters are having all this fun and they're getting involved, they're doing these spells, they're getting really dramatic, they're having so much fun, and they're thinking, we're gonna punish Macbeth, but we're gonna have a wee bit of fun with it. And then Hecate comes in and she's telling him, nope, you're gonna do it my way, I'm in charge now, how dare you go about this without me? And I think Lilith always feels at the moment Hecate joins the party, the fun kind of ends. I think she respects her because she's her high priestess and so essentially the boss. But she respects it. She respects that there is a hierarchy of sorts. I think she respects that, but it doesn't mean that she has to like it. And I think she just thinks that Hecate needs to, like, learn how to have some fun and let her hair down in a wee bit. Lilith can't be herself when Hecate's around. You feel like when Hecate joins any chants, Lilith feels that she has to pull back, and now she can no longer just indulge. And yeah, so I think that's it. I think she respects her, but she also irritates her a hell of a lot. Will the two of you get on? That's an interesting question. I think possibly. I'd like to think we would, but she is a wee bit extreme. I mean, I get some parts of her and not other parts of her. Like the fact she wants to curse an entire family for hoarding toilet roll, I get the anger over hoarding toilet roll, but she wants this man to, like, literally never know happiness again. So I think that's a little bit extreme. So I think that could be a little bit intense over time. I think, I don't know, I think it would have to be up to her, not to me. I think that's the vibe.